I've watched video of myself from this past year, kind of from another world. I've been watching, you know, how much I've grown as an artist and, you know, and as a person.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road.
I literally got to New York. We had to record the acoustics. At the end of the third week, we had all the songs done. We didn't overanalyze things. We didn't overthink it.
Just know you're not alone.
It was a lot of pressure, man. And even my producer, Greg Wattenberg, he said, man, I've never done an album this quick before.
When life leaves you high and dry, I'll be at your door tonight if you need help, if you need help.
You know, I'm so proud of the songs that are going to be on the album. I've written all the songs except two. And I hope people, you know, hear the stories that I have to tell through these songs. And hopefully they also feel the music, you know, kind of move through them as well.
You're gone, gone, gone.
Leesburg, Georgia is a very small town. It only literally has like one road. You go straight to the town and then you're right back out. You're heading to the next town. A lot of country, a lot of woods. I had a great childhood, great family. When I first started playing music, I was 14 years old. I had this karaoke machine that I always had in the living room. I would just go there every day for just hours. I would put in tapes or CDs and just rewind and listen, try to figure out each note on the guitar. I was just kept pushing myself.
Climb the mountain, swim for shore, bring it back to how it was before, take it out, blow it up.
I never thought anything would ever happen. Playing gigs 3-4 times a week, you know, working at my dad's store, and who's gonna come through Albany, Georgia and see some kid play.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next guest is, you know what this kid did? You know, take a guess. You don't know, do you? You
no,
don't know.
I don't.
I'll tell you what he did. He is this year's American Idol winner.
Hey.
How about that?
I mean, what a year it has been for you, going from your parents' pawn shop to being crowned the American Idol.
But what did you think when you heard your name called, when you stand there?
Yeah, I couldn't believe it. It's a long journey, you know. It's not as easy as it looks on TV.
The reigning American Idol champion, Phillip Phillips, his coronation song, Home, just went platinum.
This song is such a huge hit.
Did you know your song, Home, was the official song for the U.S. women's gymnastics team?
This thing shot on iTunes during the Olympics right to number one. Do you know where it was before it hit number one?
It's like 83, 84. So they gave it another life, and I'm so thankful, you know, that they wanted to use it. And it's such an honor, and like again, I can't thank them enough.
Having this, you know, all happen in such a short amount of time is, you know, it's just a blessing, because I love music so much. It's very therapeutic for me, and I'm sure it is for so many other people. And to be able to do that, to say I do this for a living, it's just amazing. Traveling all these different cities, man, and meeting all these great, you know, new people, something I never thought would happen. I always dreamed of it, like, almost every night. I mean, it sounds corny, but I mean, watching people say it on television, like, it's my dream, you know, I never thought it would happen. You know, I remember playing gigs when there'd be like 5 or 10 people there. Sometimes it would be more, but I just remember those small gigs when, you know, nobody was really listening. And now, you know, everybody's just so into it when I go out and play, and it's just an amazing feeling.